Okay, now let us take the second case. We have already earlier seen that there are three types of pivots we are going to study. Out of that, this middle one is flat collar pivot. So here the contact surface is like a ring. So this second case we will now talk about. So if you see here, here is a flat collar pivot. Now in this flat collar pivot, the drawing is drawn like this, the figure is drawn like this. And here the contact surface is like a circular disc. So this disc has got inside limit R2 and outside limit R1. So now the size is different. From the center, this much is R2 and from here to here is R1. So now the integration limits will change from R1 to R2. Earlier it was from R1 to 0 because R2 was 0. Now R2 is existing. So R1 and R2, they are the limits of integration. So how do we go about here? It's like this. Total axial load. Now last time we already derived this equation like this. W and T. So these same expressions we are using here again. So total axial load is W, and that is given by integration of P 2 pi R dr. Here the difference is integration sign is from R1 to R2. Total frictional torque is going to be T equal to pi P 2 pi mu P 2 pi R square dr. Mu P 2 pi R square dr. Integration limit is R1 and R2. Last time R2 was 0. So this W and T we are now going to evaluate for this case. So again, like last time, there are two cases. Uniform pressure case. First is uniform pressure condition. That means P is constant. So this will go outside the integration sign. So 2 pi and P, it will be outside. And inside the integration, it will be R and dr. So integration of R dr, which is 2 pi P R1 square minus R2 square. R1 square minus R2 square. This will be R1 square minus R2 square. So when you simplify, it becomes pi P because this 2 goes. So pi P R1 square minus R2 square. That is the load W. Which is quite obvious also, because if you see pi into R1 square minus R2 square, that is the area of this annular ring. So if I draw this ring like this, then what is the area of this ring? Pi R1 square minus R2 square. So that area into pressure is the total load, which is otherwise also we are aware. So that is what has come by the formula also. So W is pi P R1 square minus R2 square. So this you can jot down. Now we move on to the next part. Torque. How are we calculating the torque? So for the torque, the formula which we have earlier derived, mu P 2 pi R1 R square dr integration. So now P, pi, mu and 2 coming out of the integration sign. And inside the integration it is R square. So integration of R square, limit from R1 to R2, that gives us R1 cube minus R2 cube upon 3. So when you simplify, it becomes 2/3 mu pi P R1 cube minus R2 cube, that is torque. Now if we divide T by W, it is T in terms of W we are going to get. So this is the expression for T, this is the expression for W, and when you simplify, it becomes 2/3 mu W, because pi and P it goes. So 2/3 mu W R1 cube minus R2 cube upon R1 square minus R2 square. That becomes the final expression for T in terms of W. Rest of the things are related to distance. So the effective radius is 2/3 into this. So 2/3 into R1 cube minus R2 cube upon R1 square minus R2 square. This becomes the effective radius at which the entire load is said to be acting effectively. That means not real. It is for the mathematical purpose. We say there is a point load acting at this much distance, and that load into mu is frictional force, and frictional force into this radius becomes the torque. So that was the first case of uniform pressure. Now let's see what happens when there is uniform wear. Now for uniform wear, we have seen P into R is constant. So we denote P into R by letter C, which is same as P1 R1 or P2 R2 etc. P maximum R minimum or P minimum R maximum. So again coming to the original equations, total load equation is W P 2 pi R dr. So 2 pi P R, now here P and R is outside, R is also outside, and inside integration there is nothing left, so just dr, so the integration makes it just R. So it becomes 2 pi P R, which is C, and this integration of dr becomes R1 minus R2. So 2 pi C R1 minus R2 is W, 2 pi C R1 minus R2. Now the torque is mu P R 2 pi R dr, standard formula. Then out of that, this R is combined with P R and 1 R is left in the integration sign. So integration comes here, R dr is R square by 2, and because of integration limits as R1 and R2, it becomes R1 square minus R2 square upon 2. 2 cancels out, and that gives us T is equal to mu pi C R1 square minus R2 square. So the force is acting at an effective radius. Now before we do that, let us, since we have found out W and T, T upon W is this mu pi C R1 square minus R2 square upon 2 pi C R1 minus R2. So when you simplify it, becomes T is equal to half mu W R1 plus R2, because you know R1 square minus R2 square is R1 plus R2 into R1 minus R2. So R1 minus R2 gets cancelled out, and what is left is R1 plus R2. So half mu W R1 plus R2. So the effective radius is half R1 plus R2. Rest is mu and W. So after finding out torque, next thing is power lost. So 2 pi n t by 60, where t is this whole thing, what we have found out. So that gives us power loss in friction in the case of uniform wear. Earlier this was torque. So when you multiply 2 pi n t with t as this, that will give us the power loss in friction in case of constant pressure. So this is for constant pressure, this is for constant wear, power loss here and power loss in the earlier case. So we have found out the second case, how it is to be derived at. So for the second case, when there is a collar friction, the workout becomes like this. So you'll see that the standard formula for W and T, they are applied for every case. So for first case, in that first case there are two subtypes, constant pressure, constant wear, flat collar, constant pressure, constant wear. So we have taken 1, 2, 3, 4 cases. Total there are 3 into this 2, 6 cases. Out of 6 cases, we have seen 1, 2, 3, 4 cases. Now having seen up to this much, let us see one small application of this. Suppose there is a shaft like this, and there is some kind of an undercut given here. Now when there is an undercut given, what happens? The contact surface is only at these two places. There is a contact surface. Contact surface is here and here. Therefore, this becomes same case like a collar pivot, and there is a limit R1 and R2. Same derivation will be applicable for this case where there is a flat collar with an undercut. Flat surface with an undercut. One more thing to be noticed is, sometimes there are multiple collars. So as you see here, the shaft has got multiple collars, 1, 2, 3. And these collars are resting in the lower side. So if you see this figure, if you draw one collar like this and it is resting in a support, then the support is like this. So there is a clearance here and the contact surface is here, which has got R1 and R2 again. This is the axis. So one side is R2 and this is R1, and moreover there are 3 collars, so the load per collar is W by 3. So total load given is W, per collar it is 1/3, because 3 collars are together sharing the load, so that becomes W by 3. This we have to take into consideration. So that is what is called as collar friction, and we have seen 2 cases, constant pressure case and constant wear case, for a collar friction.